Okay, we're coming at you live on Facebook here on this snowy November day, the 15th day of the month, halfway through the month, and we're picking up snow. It's a very early season snow for us. First time we've had any snow in November in 4 years, and it's the heaviest November snowfall officially down at the airport, at least so far. It's a record for today, and it's the heaviest we've had in almost 30 years. You got to go back to the Thanksgiving Day holiday of 1989. So let's show you some of those snowfall totals that have come into the weather office so far today. And again, your backyard might have more or less than this. It varies across the region, but this is just a sampling of some of the snowfall reports that have come in. And I generally use official trained spotters that report to the National Weather Service when putting these on screen. So again, your backyard could have had more or less. Thurmont leading the way, those northern tier areas, northern Frederick, Carroll, Baltimore counties, typical, but this time around they're getting the most snow again, and that's pretty much what the models were showing yesterday, a 4 to 7 inch snowfall expected up that way, and that's kind of where we're checking in so far. Westminster with 4.8, and Norrisville 4.5, Long Green about 3 inches in Baltimore County. Lesser amounts in Cockeysville, but still a healthy 2 to 3 inches there. Here in the city, about 2 inches or so. It's pretty much changed over to rain and sleet now in the city. Columbia, about 2 inches, and there's the BWI Marshall report. And again, this I tweeted out on my Twitter page here, T-Tassel WBAL, that this was a record for the day and a record, the highest we've had since November of 1989. And that storm in November 1989 that came through on Thanksgiving holiday had 3.8 inches total. We still have a winter storm warning going through the nighttime hours for our northern suburbs, from northern Baltimore into Carroll, western Howard, western Montgomery, and Frederick County West. Again, these areas typically get the most, and they're getting more snow today because of the colder temperatures. It's an advisory along the I-95 corridor and from Queen Anne's and Kent County north on the eastern shore. You see what's going on here. Warmer temperatures have been trying to move in from the south into the lower eastern shore areas where it's primarily a rain event. But the cold is kind of hanging on tight across the northern tier there near the Pennsylvania line. We're running at or below freezing, and that is the area of most concern as far as how long it'll take to completely change over to any sleet or rain through the evening hour. So extra sleet and snow period, that means more accumulation up here, especially across that area near the Pennsylvania line where temperatures are still below freezing. And so even when we change over to rain, you might catch a little bit of ice accumulation in those colder suburbs to the north. Here's what's going on. You can see, I've got the isobars on here so we can kind of pinpoint where the storm and the high pressure cells are. In fact, if I take the radar off, and you'll just see that this area of low pressure is sitting now near the Outer Banks of North Carolina. That is the main generator. The high over New England is drifting a little farther east, and we're getting northeasterly winds coming in out of that storm, off that high pressure cell, and then the moisture coming in from the south behind it. And the end result is this wintry mix, which is pretty much all snow throughout Pennsylvania. You can see up there, cold enough for snow there, and then the wedge of cold air goes down just to the west of 95, traps that cold air in, and we get the snow and the sleet. Eventually, the warm air with that storm is, I think, is gonna win out. Our winds are gonna go more to the east-southeast perhaps overnight tonight, and that's gonna try to push in some warmer temperatures, so that rain-snow line will likely move a little bit farther north slowly through the evening hours. Now, radar's been trying to detect where the changeover is happening, and I think it's lagging behind a little bit because we've had mostly rain and only a little bit of sleet here in the city for quite a while now, and the radar is just now picking up on that changeover in the city. But you can see that the radar is indicating it's still mostly snow here to the north and west, northwestern Baltimore County, Carroll County, Frederick. You might have a little sleet mixed in. Also up here in Cecil and Harford counties, getting some pretty good snow still coming down. But the changeover has already been happening now in the city. It's rain to the south of Baltimore, and then that rain-sleet mixture there in northwest Baltimore. I just stepped out a little while ago, and we had mostly rain, a little sleet. Same thing eastern Howard County. Western Howard, where the terrain is a little higher and the temperatures are cooler, in these areas north and west, you get more snow. Same thing Harford and Cecil counties. Looks like still mainly snow up that way. I know Taylor Grenda was in here earlier talking to her parents over in Delaware, and they were getting some pretty good snows up there, so it does look like that snow is hanging on in northern Delaware. Where it changes to rain and continues as rain through the evening, we may have another problem. A flood watch is up from Baltimore south into southern Maryland, eastern shore. Pretty good rains coming in tonight, and that could cause some localized flooding. It may well also take us over the top as far as being the wettest year on record with that rain coming in. So here's the scenario. The storm to our south takes its path up along the east coast and then gradually moves out to sea off the New England coast. It'll track like that and be gone by tomorrow morning. But watch this second system out here. This is the upper level low pressure area that's sitting out over the Ohio Valley. And it's going to be interesting to see this track through because it's got a pocket of energy with it. And I think as it's making its way through our region late tonight after midnight, it may bring a secondary burst of snow. And I'm even waiting to see if when the center of this passes through, we might hear a little overnight thunder. It'll be interesting to see if that happens. It's a pretty potent little low pressure system in the upper atmosphere, and it's going to track right over us tonight. So here's Futurecast taking us through 9 o'clock. Notice that the rain snow line goes all the way back into Frederick County. So we are anticipating a continued changeover from snow and sleet to mostly rain in the Baltimore metro area by 9 o'clock tonight. So between now and then, just about everybody should change over. And then we continue with rain until about 2, 3 o'clock in the morning when that western system is coming through. Notice the rain changes back to snow briefly, especially west of Baltimore. And you might pick up another inch or two as that system moves through late tonight, early in the morning on the west side of this system. By the morning rush hour, it's gone, and throughout most of the day tomorrow, I think we're going to be able to enjoy lots of sunshine behind this departing storm system. So that's the way it's looking right now. We have a couple more hours where we'll have to deal with this wintry mix, but slowly improving with rain overnight, one last burst of snow late tonight, and then some sunshine tomorrow. Now, Shannon is here. If you hear her coughing, excuse her because she is battling a cold. And so, Shannon, what do we got going on as far as questions, comments?
A lot of questions we're getting about the possibility of icy roads tonight. And before you, I know I just asked that, we've also gotten several people mention I-70, and just so people know, state police have been updating throughout the day. Different parts of I-70 have been shut down because of icy conditions.
Oh, okay.
One bad spot earlier was 70 east-west of Braddock Road. It was closed earlier. It was back open as of 2, but only one lane's open. And SHA was still treating the surface. But we also just got in on I-70 west that the 40 alternate exit is currently closed.
Oh, wow, okay.
And the surface is covered in ice and a tractor trailer jackknife blocking all the lanes.
Wow.
So
that's nasty.
Just so people know, I-70, we've been getting reports. Yeah. So different sections have been closed.
Okay.
And they're, you know, slowly opening and then a different section's closed because of the icy conditions.
That's the worst part now on I-70 as far as the major highways go?
Yes, excuse me,
there
too.
Yeah, okay. All right, well, yeah, we can see the temperatures out there in the western sections where Shannon was talking about that. You can see the Shannon was talking about temperatures being cold enough to cause icy conditions. So 32 Catonsville, just above freezing Columbia. Go west to Mount Airy, though, and you're below freezing. And that continues westbound on 70 through Frederick into Washington County. So you're going to very be careful here with those icy conditions. Same thing up in the northern tier, up 83, probably going to get a little slick up that way, especially as the sun gets lower in the sky this evening. So even if it does change over to rain in your neighborhood where these temperatures are at or below freezing, be on the lookout for those icy patches for sure.
And just if you can kind of explain freezing rain, sleet, you know, the differences.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We've had a couple questions about that.
Yeah, I should have made a graphic for that. But basically, rain is just raindrops falling. Sleet is rain that falls and freezes before it hits the ground. And so it comes down. Most of the world calls it ice pellets. And that's more descriptive, really, of what it is. It's like an ice pebble or pellet falling from the sky. So it's a raindrop that freezes and then falls to the ground as a chunk of ice or ice pellet. That's sleet. Freezing rain is just rain that doesn't freeze until it hits something cold on the ground, like your car top or your railing on your sidewalk or something like that. That's frozen, and so when the liquid rain falls on it, then it causes a glaze of ice to form. So freezing rain is rain that falls and freezes. Sleet is an ice pellet. That is rain that freezes up in the clouds and comes down as a chunk of ice. And snow is when you have a really deep layer of cold air and it just crystallizes into a snowflake and makes it all the way down.
Do you mind going over Futurecast again?
Yeah, let's go back to Futurecast. That's always probably the most important thing that we look at here as far as the computer model is giving us some timing on this. So here we are, 2:30 or so going toward 3 o'clock, and the models are indicating that rain-snow line continuing to press farther north. I think by 6, we're going to see most areas with a good deal of rain. There may be some areas just to our north that still have some sleet, but certainly by 8 or 9, we're almost all rain in the Baltimore metro area and point south. That continues into midnight until about 2 o'clock in the morning, when that western system comes through and changes our western areas back over to snow briefly, maybe another coating to an inch or two, and then that's gone by the morning rush hour. 5 a.m. we're done. Skies are clearing up, and we shouldn't have any problem until Friday morning rush hour. Temperatures may be a little tricky as far as icy patches go, but the precipitation's gone. And look at this, the sunshine continues. And if I show you the 7-day forecast, it's actually pretty bizarre to see this much of quiet weather recently in our area. Once this storm leaves, oops, that's not right. Let's see here. That was definitely not right. Here, once that storm leaves, we've got 7 days of, you know, the highest precipitation chance is 20%. That's on Sunday and Monday, so really nothing going on there other than a few clouds. Chilly temperatures. Normal high is in the 50s, but these are only going to be in the 40s. But look at that. Seven days.
We haven't had a full week like that in some time in the past year, it seems.
Yeah, look at that. Take a gander at that 7-day forecast. That's pretty nice. 7 days of dry weather. So we may set the record tonight for the all-time wettest year, but then we're going to go into a week of dry weather.
Okay, and then we'll see you later tonight.
Tell me when we're going to see me. Tell me what's going on here.
We're going to have a special at 4 o'clock.
Yeah. And Taylor Grand is here.
Yep. And then 5 and 6. And then we'll be here, obviously, through the night monitoring things as usual.
4, 5, and 6. We might see you back here on Facebook later tonight as we update the storm moving through. But 4 o'clock is our next news update on Channel 11. So be safe out there. Enjoy the snow and the nice weather that's coming in behind us.
Thanks, Tom.
All right.